Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Mary Washington from Farm Tamer Productions. I want to welcome you all to the series that I am hosting, Music in Stressful Times. And Farm Tamer Productions, it actually comes with a holistic and functional wellness through music and entertainment. And the addition is music, a frontliner to COVID. Now, you may be wondering what a frontliner is, but it's generally a person that you will have a connection to or have communication with that represent a particular brand or company. Well, let's just say music is your frontliner. It is a connection to get through these stressful moments and these stressful times. And of course, I am inviting some friends over to talk to them about music, its impact on our lives and on their lives, as well as the unique world of music through their eyes and their perspective. Because as we know, music has a historical footprint that is unique to each individual. But before we get started, the information provided by Farm Tamer Productions is for informational purposes only and is not intended as a medical advice, a substitute for medical advice, diagnosis, treatment, or a guarantee of an outcome. The lovely individual I have today with me, and I am so excited that she is here, is none other than an Augusta native. She is an urban violinist. So I know, and I'm certain most of you all have seen her perform around the CSRA and as well as nationwide. And she also achieved her Bachelor of Science degree and Master's degree in music education. It is, and I want to welcome Javon Smith. Hey, how are you today?
Look, you know it's Jones, it's not Smith. Now, maybe you tell, maybe you're foreseeing some future. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Well, I apologize. I'm giving you a name.
I'm a JJ, Javon Jones. It's awesome.
All right, Javon Jones.
I am glad to be here. I appreciate the opportunity to talk to you guys on today. I don't know. I met Mary. It's been like a month, maybe two, maybe 2 months ago. Mm-hmm. So grateful that she thought enough of me to be on here with you guys on today.
Yes, yes, yes. And I appreciate you being here. Of course, we're speaking about music in stressful times, but as well as just our world of music. And just to get started, I'm wondering, where does music start with you?
Oh, goodness. The weird thing is that I only remember, I know it sounds really bad, but I only remember my music teacher. My only teacher I really, really remember from elementary school is my music teacher. Mm-hmm. That class gave me so much life as a kindergartner. And I knew that it must have some type of musical ability, because that's the only class that I could appreciate really as a kid. And then as I went into middle and high school, I mean, those are the teachers that stuck with me, because that was a part of me, you know. Music was literally a part of me in my life, and it's what I relate to, and it's what's that healing for me, and it's what I use to like get through situations. And so it's that connection. So I remember, you know, my music teachers all through school. And so here I am now, you know, I'm trying to impact children's lives, you know, through music as well. And then try to touch the masses with my music when I'm performing it on the violin. And, you know, I've always said that I want to be an impact, because the impact that another musician had on me was just like unbelievable. That there was this one person that really touched my life through violin, to the point where it was like, I have to learn to play that. You know, I have to learn that instrument. Don't even really know what it is. And I'm a little kid, but it's like, I really have to learn how to play this. And that person today, like, literally does not probably even know they had that type of impact on my life. But that's what I want to do for other people, for children, for adults. I mean, for anybody. So yeah, that's how my world is with music in regards to, you know, me wanting to reach the masses through my music, whether it's through education, whether it's through performance, whatever way I want to be able to be an impact.
Mm-hmm. And it's very important to note that you did say music is healing, and it's just not only a connection, it is healing. And just to back up just a point from the connection point of view, even if it's through your performance and you chose violin to actually deliver that, I'm wondering if even at that, as a musician, your gift is being expressed through the violin. So it's mostly not a verbal connection, and it's just a musical outlet and how you express from a, just a lack of explaining a spiritual ramification to come through and speak to you, to this violin, and it just speaks to others. Mm-hmm. That connection, a lot of times, is just, it's unexplainable. But it is unique, and it is there, and it does impact lives. And I appreciate you doing that. Now, I was wondering, of course, in these stressful moments, I know the gig economy is taking an impact on all of us regarding the musicianships and all. But I'm wondering, how are you using your music at this moment to minimize stress or and to inspire?
Well, let me say this. I know I probably drive my neighbors crazy because I am playing all day long. And, you know, they hear me practicing all the time, you know, because I get like my neighbor come over, is like, what's that song you was playing last night? You know, it's kind of cool. But now it gives me a whole lot more time to really put into my craft. And, you know, you look at the pandemic as, you know, negative. We very seldom look at any positive coming out of it. You don't really want to say pandemic positive, but yet there is a silver lining in it all. Yes, to the point where it is something positive that's coming out of it. Mm-hmm. And so it gives me more time to practice. It gives me time to take up another instrument. I've never really been a writer. I mean, I am big on improvisation, but I've never really been a songwriter. So I wrote my first song since I've been in here. You know what I mean? Just different things that I have never really taken the time or had the time to sit down and really do. It's given me that time to really focus on those things. So as long as I don't have any news on, as long as I'm not going outside, as long as I'm minimizing my social media time and I don't really get caught up in what's really going on around me, I very seldom think about the fact that, hey, there's a pandemic outside my door, you know? And so I'm like usually good. So I find my happy place in here, you know, when I'm performing. And I told you earlier that music is healing for me. For me, in my eyes, music is healing, and there's research that supports it, but it does something for me. So whereas a lot of times we're playing music and people think that we're playing music because of them, yep. You know, a lot of times we're playing the music for our own selves to make our own selves feel better too. So not only do we want to touch other people and make them feel better, it does something for us to get our emotions out through what we're playing. And so I appreciate that in this moment, you know, I'm spending this time to keep my anxiety low by playing my instrument. And then I started revamping some things that I used to do in the past. I used to do a Sunday night series called Sunday Night Live and kind of got away from it a little bit. And then like the first week that we were on Shelter in Place, I said, I'm going to bring back Sunday Night Live because Sunday Night Live was something that the people look forward to. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I realized that we need something that just brings us together that will make us like not focus on what's going on around us, but just for that hour, sometimes hour and a half, just spend time together having fun. You know, I'm big on old school, so I do a lot of old school music. You know, I'm a 80s baby, but I grew up in the 90s. So like, I play a lot of 90s music because, you know, a lot of my following is, you know, that age realm where they can like really relate to that. So, you know, I'm just trying to give people you know, an opportunity to just forget just for that moment and let's have a good time.
Right.
And I try to be that person that helps them, you know, have a good time in this moment, to kind of give them some peace, and, you know, kind of ease their anxiety a little bit.
See, music is powerful. And it's funny you're saying it because this is the time we can take up on any craft or chore, or even if it's because spring cleaning, but with music itself, because I know with me, my vocals, practicing that is an instrument, that is my instrument, my vocals. Of course, I play the violin, I pick that up and I do about 15 minutes and I take out my anger and frustrations and trying to get scales right on it. And but just practicing and getting emotionally connected, relieving the stress. And even if you don't play music, even if you don't play an instrument itself, that connection and listening to other people, music, your music. Of course, I'm an 80s baby. And the 90s music is, of course, what I enjoy myself. And just turning on the radio, listening to some Monica and just dancing or whatever the case may be to just minimize, relieve stress, kind of give yourself an escape, or myself an escape at that, from what's going on in our society, in our community, or just, you know, to minimize that stress and move on from there. Now, I do have another question for you. And that question is, within this moment that we are experiencing, what song you would choose that will represent our moment? And yeah, that will represent our moment.
Let me see, something that will represent. I'll tell you, the first thing that came to me was A Change Gonna Come. And that's the first thing that popped in my head when you said it. Because let me tell you, I look at things kind of outside the box a little bit. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think about, you know, we're in this pandemic now and the types of things that we're having to do to kind of navigate to make it through, especially us as musicians. You know, we're trying to be innovative. We're trying to come up with ways that we can still make, you know, some income while we're on the inside. And like, it's made us pull out so much creativity to just make some stuff work. And I was having a conversation with my mom today about, you know, the income that I've made since I've been inside doing things that I just never thought about doing in regards to performance. And it's still using like a lot of the same platforms like Zoom, you know, streaming apps, using social media, you know, people, this is having an effect on everybody. They can't celebrate like they usually do. So, you know, I find myself now, people are reaching out to me to do special private celebrations through Facebook groups and things, mm-hmm. to do special things for their loved ones because we just can't gather. So, but we can gather on social media, you know, virtually. Yeah. So, mm-hmm. you know, just things that you just never really thought about that, mm-hmm. you know, it makes you, you know, focus on doing. And so when you think about when all of this is over, you know, you've been you know, doing your private events on social media, and you've been teaching your lessons on Zoom, and mm-hmm. you know, you've been teaching classes on Zoom, all these things. You know, what's the world going to be like after this? It's never going to be the same. Right. We are never going to be the same. And I think this moment has evoked change.
Yes.
And for everyone, I have some major changes and shifts that's going to happen in my life in general, and even bigger things just because this pandemic has happened. And I mean, just things are just not going to be the same. They're probably going to look at education differently, you know, mm-hmm. going forward. Parents are going to start thinking, oh, I did a really good job teaching my kid, mm-hmm. you know, or whatever, people that usually get their hair done and things like that. I got a friend that said, oh, I did my own nails. I ain't paying $45 no more to go get my nails. But it makes you have to do it.
Right.
And we've been a month in, but after this month is over and it's another month or maybe even another month, we don't know, but mm-hmm. people are going to start learning how to make it work. We're just going to end up adapting.
Right.
Like right at the beginning, it's like we're complaining, right? We don't like it. We're uncomfortable. We're in our complaining stage of it. But now a lot of the complaining has stopped. School's still out. Parents know they out, you know. But a lot of that complaining that used to happen has started to simmer down because they in the month they figured out how to make it work.
Mm-hmm.
And so in the next month, it's going to be some other stuff. It's just like, dog, I still can't get a haircut. But they're going to be to order them clippers and they're going to end up getting on that YouTube and learning how to give them a fade or temp fade or whatever.
Yes,
you know, people are going to learn what to do.
Mm-hmm.
And in retrospect, though, it could be a benefit, but then it can also not be so much because it's going to affect businesses and things like that. The things that we used to feel like was a commodity or something that, you know, we had to pay for. Now, you know, I'm like, I can do that myself. I found out in this moment that this is something I can do myself, you mm-hmm. know. So it's like a bittersweet type thing, you know.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I'm pretty sure that a lot of changes are going to come. They're going to look at healthcare. They're going to look at all these things.
Oh, yes.
Our hospitals and see what we're lacking. And, you know, it's going to be so much. And so I would have to say Change Go Come is probably the song that kind of hit me the most when you're talking about what we're going through right now and where we're going.
That's true. A lot of change is going to be going to come from this because, of course, the coronavirus outbreak itself has exposed many of, you want to say, I would like to say the weaknesses, but I would like to also refer to it as opportunities for us to mm-hmm. actually make it better from our healthcare systems.
Absolutely.
From our healthcare system, even to our service jobs, even if it's environmental services or individuals that are doing hair, nails, how are we going to approach this, education, et cetera. Yes. The song I also thought about was also What's Going On
by Mark. Yeah,
that song is relevant. Even it's within this time and just dating back that song to the times of the national movements when it was involved with the civil rights movements and et cetera, it's appropriate for this time itself.
Absolutely. It's an eye-awakening experience for everyone. And you know, I don't take this Vision 2020 thing lightly. You know, everybody, you know, coming in the year, everybody's like, 2020 vision. I need clear vision. And when I say, if this is not giving people a clear vision or they're not awakened by this experience and they think that this is just happenstance, no, this is literally like, if you didn't know God before this
mm-hmm.
moment and know that he was real,
mm-hmm.
You know now. Right. You should. And if you're not woke, you know, it's a problem.
Yes. And it's funny you said that, because when you actually said that phase made me thought about Kirk Franklin, Jesus is real. But yes, I really, I thank you for stopping by. And Javon Jones, you guys, this is the urban violinist, Javon Jones. I have to get that correct. I don't know where that name came from, but I apologize for that.
All right.
And thank you so much. And I want to also say thank you for you all taking the time to listen and tune in here at Farmtainment Productions. This video will be available to see at Farmtainment Productions on Facebook as well as YouTube. And I'll be sharing the link at LinkedIn as well. And you can visit www.farmtainment.com for more information and as to the services that are provided. But in the meantime, we'll see you later.
Bye. Thank you, Mary.
Thank you.